Hello and welcome to this Ash Wednesday service to mark the beginning of Lent. The service is a service of Holy Communion, and most of the liturgy, the words, is from a website called Sacredis. I'm afraid I forgot to acknowledge that on the last slide. The communion prayers is Church of England, common worship, but the rest of it is, as I say, from Sacredis. A little different to help us stop and think about what we are doing, to recommit ourselves once more to following God, to following Jesus. So first there is a call to worship. As soon as Jesus was baptized, he went up out of the water. At that moment, heaven was opened, and he saw the Spirit of God descending like a dove and lighting on him. And a voice from heaven said, "This is my Son, whom I love. With him I am well pleased." And Jesus was led by the Spirit into the desert. So as we follow Jesus' example, let's say these words together. We seek to follow you, Lord Jesus.
Lead us by your Spirit into a season of preparation and of growing faith. Amen.
And we now have our hymn, 40 Days and 40 Nights.
Zealous commitment, it's your kindness that has softened our hearts and led us to your arms.
We praise and thank you, O Lord.
It is your devotion to us that's given us the courage to commit ourselves to you.
We praise and thank you, O Lord.
It is your invitation that has inspired us to take upon us your yoke and find purpose, meaning and rest.
We praise and thank you, O Lord.
Receive again our offering of worship, of love and of our lives. This is our sacrifice of praise for your blessing and glory. God of our hearts. Amen. Would you join in the Amen after the collect for today? Almighty and everlasting God, you hate nothing you have made, and forgive the sins of all those who are penitent. Create and make in us new and contrite hearts, that we, worthily lamenting our sins and acknowledging our wretchedness, may receive from you, the God of all mercy, perfect remission and forgiveness, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Amen. Our Old Testament reading comes from the 58th chapter of the book of Isaiah the prophet. Shout out and do not hold back. Lift up your voice like a trumpet. Announce to my people their rebellion, to the house of Jacob their sins. Yet day after day they seek me, and delight to know my ways, as if they were a nation that practiced righteousness and did not forsake the ordinance of their God. They ask of me righteous judgments. They delight to draw near to God. Why do we fast, but you do not see? Why humble ourselves, but you do not notice? Look, you serve your own interests on your fast day and oppress all your workers. Look, you fast only to quarrel and to fight and to strike with a wicked fist. Such fasting as you do today will not make your voice heard on high. Is such the fast that I choose, a day to humble oneself? Is it to bow down the head like a bulrush and to lie in sackcloth and ashes? Will you call this a fast, a day acceptable to the Lord? Is this not the fast that I choose, to loose the bonds of the injustice, to undo the thongs of the yoke, to let the oppressed go free and to break every yoke? Is it not to share your bread with the hungry and bring the homeless and poor into your house, when you see the naked to cover them and not to hide yourself from your own kin? Then your light shall break forth like the dawn, and your healing shall spring up quickly. Your vindicator shall go before you, and the glory of the Lord will answer. Lost my place. Then you shall call, and the Lord will answer. You will cry for help, and he will say, "Here I am." If you remove the yoke from you, the pointing finger, the speaking of evil, if you offer your food to the hungry and satisfy the needs of the afflicted, then your light shall rise in the darkness, and your gloom will be like the noonday. The Lord will guide you continually and satisfy your needs in parched places and make your bones strong. And you will be like a water garden, like a spring of water whose waters never fail. Your ancient ruins will be rebuilt. You shall raise up the foundations of many generations. You shall be called the repairer of the breach, the restorer of streets to live in. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Reading is taken from 2 Corinthians chapter 5 verses 20 to chapter 6 verse 10. So we are ambassadors of Christ, since God is making his appeal through us. We entreat you on behalf of Christ. Be reconciled to God, for our sake he has made him to be a sin who knew no sin, so that in him we might become the righteousness of God. As we work together with him, we urge you also not to accept the grace of God in vain, for he says, an acceptable time, I have listened to you, and on the day of salvation, I have helped you. See, now is the acceptable time. See, now is the day of salvation. We are putting no obstacles in anyone's way, so that no fault may be found with our ministry. But as servants of God, we are commended ourselves in every way, through great endurance, in afflictions, hardships, calamities, beatings, imprisonment, riots, labours, sleepless nights, hunger, by purity, knowledge, patience, kindness, holiness of spirit, genuine love, truthful speech, and the power of God, with the weapons of righteousness for the right hand and for the left, in honour and dishonour, and ill repute and good repute. We are treated as impostors and yet are true, as unknown and yet are well known, as dying and see, we are alive, as punished and yet not killed, as sorrowful yet always rejoicing, as poor yet making many rich, as having nothing and yet possessing everything. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
And it's John chapter 8, verses 2 to 11. Oof. Early in the morning, Jesus came again to the temple. All the people came to him, and he sat down and began to teach them. The scribes and the Pharisees brought a woman who had been caught in adultery, and making her stand before all of them, they said to him, "Teacher, this woman was caught in the very act of committing adultery. Now, in the law, Moses commanded us to stone such women. Now, what do you say?" They said this to test him, so that they might have some charge to bring against him. Jesus bent down and wrote with his finger on the ground. When they kept on questioning him, he straightened up and said to them, "Let anyone among you who is without sin be the first to throw a stone at her." And once again he bent down and wrote on the ground. When they heard it, they went away one by one, beginning with the elders, and Jesus was left alone with the woman standing before him. Jesus straightened up and said to her, "Woman, where are they? Has no one condemned you?" She said, "No one, sir." And Jesus said, "Neither do I condemn you. Go your way, and from now on, do not sin again." This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. And we have got our reflection for the beginning of Lent by our bishop, Bishop Michael.
Ash Wednesday, the start of the great 40 days of Lent that lead up to the Feast of Easter. Lent, of course, for us is a time of going into the wilderness with Jesus, of reflecting more deeply on what the Spirit is doing in our lives, of reading the scriptures more attentively, of spending more time in prayer, of disciplining ourselves, for some through prayer, through fasting, through giving, and particularly today of remembering our dependence on God in the sign of the ashes, from which Ash Wednesday gets its name, the marking on our foreheads of the dust of the earth as a reminder of our physical frailty and of our dependence on God, who brought us from the earth and who we hope will raise us up from the earth as he raised Jesus from the dead. This Lent, we keep surrounded by reminders of mortality and limitation. In a time of pandemic, death and loss all around us, and with restrictions on our movements and on our meetings. And of course these things cause us great sadness, and they can cause us frustration too. But they can also be an opportunity for us to turn again to God. We cannot meet physically with family and friends as we would want to, but we can meet spiritually with God in the depths of our hearts. We cannot travel physically to other places, but we can explore the unbounded breadth and depth of God's love for us. We cannot join physically in parties and sports and concerts and horse races and entertainments, whatever else we want to do that would entertain us. But that means that there is nothing to distract us from the presence of the God whose service is joy and life beyond measure. So today, it may be that you are marking on your forehead the sign of the ashes, or it may be that you're not. But whether you do that or not, remember that this Lent is a time to draw closer to God and to travel with Jesus into the wilderness so that we may share with him in the joy of his resurrection. May God keep you safe and bless you in your keeping of this Lent.
Come now to a time of confession. Holy and most beautiful Lord, we are humbled by your compassion and mercy. We recognise that within us is much that has hurt and offended you. We acknowledge our faults and findings and admit that we do not deserve your dedication to us. Just have a time of silence just to think about our own words as we bring these things to God. But now, empowered by your grace, given to us through Jesus' life, death and resurrection, we come to renew our commitment and deepen our relationship with you. Saying together, we recognise, O Lord, that we are simply dust. Remind us through these ashes of our dependence on you and your love for us. May we know the strength of your spirit as we seek to follow you. May we know the discipline of your love as we seek to draw nearer to you. May we know the insight of your wisdom as we seek to learn of you. As we receive the ashes upon our foreheads, may we know the joy of sharing with you in ministry, in suffering, in death and in life, for your glory and your kingdom's sake. Amen.
Dear friends in Christ, I invite you to receive these ashes, and there's some there. If you want to come and join us that side. So we've got ashes prepared, and if you have ashes or some other way of marking yourself, as the bishop said, it doesn't matter whether you've got ash or not, but please feel free to join in with the marking of the cross on the forehead, and in solidarity with you at home who are probably marking yourself,
we are going to mark ourselves, the three of us, simultaneously as I say the words, and I invite you to join us in doing that. A little different from the usual row of people and taking your turns. So, dear friends in Christ, I invite you to receive these ashes as a sign of the spirit of penitence with which we shall keep this season of Lent. God our Father, you create us from the dust of the earth. Grant that these ashes may be for us a sign of our penitence and a symbol of our mortality. For it is by your grace alone that we receive eternal life. In Jesus Christ, our Saviour. Amen. So we make the sign of the cross. Remember, you are dust, and to dust you shall return. Turn away from sin and be faithful to Christ. Let us confess our sins in penitence and faith. I know we've already had a confession, but these will be familiar words. If you know them, join in. God of mercy, we acknowledge that we are all sinners. We turn from the wrong that we have thought and said and done, and are mindful of all that we have failed to do. For the sake of Jesus who died for us, forgive us all that is past, and help us to live each day in the light of Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, who sent his Son into the world to save sinners, bring you his pardon and his peace, now and forever. God our Father, the strength of all who put their trust in you, because in our weakness we can do nothing good without you, grant us the help of your grace, that in keeping your commandments we may please you both in will and deed, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. So, we move now to some prayers of request. I'd like to go back to our seats. I'll go to the left and find a tissue. God of eternal love, we know that if we are to remain faithful, we need your help and your strength. So we ask. Teach us to pray with faith and read your word with understanding. Teach us to worship with passion and gather together with your love. Teach us to give generously, serve compassionately, and use our time mindfully, so that we may reflect your goodness and that others may discover your grace through us. In Jesus' name, Amen. I invite you to stand if you're not already for the peace. Since we are justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us access to his grace. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
To offer one another a wave of peace.
Peace with you.
Peace be with you.
Peace be with you. Love the victims.
So we have our next song, Oh Let the Son of God Enfold You. Peace be with you.
We're allowed.
Yeah, we are.
It's my cross.
It's your cross.
Thank you.
So we come to the great prayer of thanksgiving, and I gather that we have lost the live connection. We don't get any warning when it's going to run out of internet juice. It's not off. We've not run out of juice, apparently. It's just stopped working. So you're watching this later on, because we are recording it. So we thank God for the technology to be able to record as well as live stream. So wherever you are in time, God's outside of time. So we still gather around this table together. The Lord is here.
His Spirit is with us.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give thanks and praise. It is indeed right and good to give you thanks and praise, Almighty God and everlasting Father, through Jesus Christ your Son. For in these 40 days you lead us into the desert of repentance, that through a pilgrimage of prayer and discipline we may grow in grace and learn to be your people once again. Through fasting, prayer and acts of service, you bring us back to your generous heart. Through study of your holy word, you open our eyes to your presence in the world and free our hands to welcome others into the radiant splendour of your love. As we prepare to celebrate the Easter feast with joyful hearts and minds, we bless you for your mercy and join with saints and angels forever praising you and saying, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Accept our praises, Heavenly Father, through your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. And as we follow his example and obey his command, grant that by the power of your Holy Spirit, these gifts of bread and wine may be to us his body and blood, who in the same night that he was betrayed, took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. Therefore, Heavenly Father, we remember his offering of himself, made once for all upon the cross. We proclaim his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension. We look for the coming of your kingdom. And with this bread and this cup, we make the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Lord. Great is the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Accept through him, our great high priest, this our sacrifice of thanks and praise. And as we eat and drink these holy gifts in the presence of your divine majesty, renew us by your Spirit, inspire us with your love, and unite us in the body of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Through him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, with all who stand before you in earth and heaven, we worship you, Father Almighty, in songs of everlasting praise. Blessing and honour and glory and power be yours forever and ever. Amen. As our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Grant us peace. Draw near with faith. The body of our Lord Jesus Christ and his blood, which was given for you, preserve your body and soul to everlasting life. Take and eat this in remembrance that Christ died for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. Amen. Amen. Most merciful Lord, your love compels us to come in. Our hands were unclean, our hearts were unprepared. We were not fit even to eat the crumbs from under your table. But you, Lord, are the God of our salvation, and share your bread with sinners. So cleanse and feed us with the precious body and blood of your Son, that he may live in us and we in him, and that we, with the whole company of Christ, may sit and eat in your kingdom. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty God, you have given your only Son to be for us both a sacrifice for sin and also an example of godly life. Give us grace that we may always most thankfully receive these his inestimable gifts, and also daily endeavour to follow the blessed steps of his most holy life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Now come, all you who are loved by God, hear his call to serve others as he has served you. Hear his invitation to be part of his plan to rescue the world. Join in the community of those who walk in the footsteps of Jesus. We say together, Lord God of world-changing love, we thank you for this meal and for welcoming us to your table. We remember that we are your children and that you have called us to share your love with everyone we meet. Help us to receive your life, walk in your strength, and follow your ways every moment of our lives. Amen. May Christ give you grace to grow in holiness, to deny yourselves, take up your cross and follow him. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen.
Amen.
So let us join together with the hymn, Lead Us, Heavenly Father, Lead Us into Lent.
Serve the Lord.
In the name of Christ. Amen.